The final algorithm we'll discuss, which we're going to call sort, then reduce by key, is one that I'll just sketch out, primarily because we haven't discussed the underlying algorithms yet. We'll get to them in the next lecture. However, it'll be a great mental exercise for you to think about how you might implement this approach. Let's think about our entries, here we have 8 entries, as key value pairs. The key is the bin number, and in this example, we're going to have 3 bins, 0, 1, and 2, and the value is 1, which we're going to add to each bin. This algorithm has 2 steps. The first is a sort, the second is a reduce. So first, let's look at the sort. We're going to sort the key value pairs by key. So here's our keys. And notice it's the same key value pairs that we have up here, but now they're in ascending order by key. And the second step is to reduce the result by key. Naturally enough, this algorithm is called reduce by key. What I mean here is to add all the elements that have the same key together. So we'd like to add these 4 ones up to create the reduction value of 4. Or more generally, to reduce these values using a reduction operator. Note that all elements with the same key are contiguous, which is the key to making an efficient implementation. Now again, this is likely not something you can do with the algorithms that you know so far, but libraries of parallel primitives may have implementations for both of these operations. For instance, the thrust library that accompanies a CUDA distribution implements both sort and reduce by key methods. Thinking about how you might implement these 2 operations is worth your time over the next week.